When preparing a sample for the NMR, there's a couple important things to remember so that your sample is ready for analysis and that you don't mess up any of the important solvents or tools that we've got to prepare these. So let's get started. All right, so here's what we're going to need. We're going to have NMR tubes. These are special glass tubes that are closed on one end and then open on the other end. These tubes are not like pasteur pipettes. They actually cost several dollars a piece, so each tube costs a few dollars. So these things you want to handle carefully, and they're definitely not disposable. So there should always they should always be collected by the TA. Make sure you don't throw any of these away. So you'll have the NMR tubes, you'll have a cap, a yellow cap for that tube, and a pipette and a pipette bulb. And then we've got our sample, our solvent. This solvent happens to be deuterated chloroform, which is one that you'll be using quite a bit. There's also another solvent called deuterated DMSO that you may be instructed to use from time to time. So actual sample, in this case my sample happens to be a solid, and I've already weighed out about 10 to 15 milligrams. So 10 to 15 milligrams is not very much. You can see in relation to my finger, it may be kind of the size of the tip of my pinky. So you don't want too much sample inside of this tube, or it'll oversaturate your analysis. If you have too little in there, you may not get a clean NMR. So make sure you have 10 to 15 milligrams weighed out. And then that 10 to 15 milligrams is going to go directly inside of the NMR tube. So I'm going to just kind of gingerly pour this in, make a little bend in my filter paper, and then pour this in slowly. So I used a little bit of movie magic there because it's really difficult to do that pour with the filter paper unless you're right on top of it. But you can see the solid that's down in the bottom, and you've got this whole NMR tube. You need 10 to 15 milligrams, which fills up about that much of the tube. So once you've got your sample in there, you're going to need to add your solvent. To know how much solvent you need to add, you're going to refer to the solvent guide that's actually on the front of the hood. So this is the solvent guide that I was referring to. You can see there's a drawing that exactly matches the length of your tube. Can't see the tube too well, it blends in, but the crossed lines show the ideal range for your solvent. So you want to add just enough chloroform, deuterated chloroform, so that you can make it somewhere in between that ideal solvent range that you see on this guide. So if you don't happen to have a solvent guide where you are, it's usually ends up being about 0.75 to a mil of your solvent. Since I've done this several times, I kind of have a feel for how much goes in. So I'm gonna pick up my deuterated chloroform and then kind of squirt that in, trying to wash all of the solid off the walls of the NMR tube. Make sure I get all the chloroform in there. One thing that you want to be really important of is not to contaminate this deuterated chloroform. So once you've used a pipette, you want to make sure to dispose of that in the pipette waste, and don't try to put the same pipette in again, especially if you've touched the lip of your NMR tube where it could be contaminated with whatever sample you're studying. This NMR solvent is really expensive, and if it gets contaminated, wore out the $75-$50 bucks that it costs to get this solvent. So make sure that you're just extra careful about contaminating that chloroform solvent. So once you've got the correct amount of sample in there, or solvent, you're going to put the cap on, and then if your sample didn't dissolve all the way, you want to kind of invert it several times until everything is dissolved into that solvent. Your TA may ask you if chloroform is not sufficient to dissolve your sample. Your TA may ask you to put maybe 1 to 2 drops at the most of DMSO, which is a little bit more polar and can help some of those more polar solids dissolve into your NMR solvent. And that dissolution is really important for the actual sample run. So that's it. You've got your NMR sample. It's filled up to the proper height on the solvent guide, and then you're ready to submit this to your TA to run the NMR. Because the NMR spectra are so important to you being able to solve the structure of your compounds, you want to make sure that you prepare your sample correctly, just as we did in this video, so that when you get your NMR spectrum, you're able to analyze that and utilize all that valuable data that comes out of that spectra. So hopefully you prepared it well in lab and you end up with a great spectra to analyze in your notebook. Good luck in the lab.